What's up, guys? Sempre é muito divertido mostrar os brasileiros falando inglês para os meus amigos, para os outros nativos de inglês, principalmente os professores de inglês, para saber o que eles acham do sotaque brasileiro, o que eles acham sobre o jeito que eles falam inglês. Então, hoje vou entrar aqui no aplicativo Cambly, vou passar os clipes das celebridades brasileiras falando inglês para eles ver e reagir o que eles acham dos brasileiros, das celebridades falando em inglês. Se vocês ainda não conhecem esse aplicativo, é um aplicativo muito, muito útil se vocês estão tentando melhorar seu inglês pelas conversas. Se vocês usam esse código, vocês vão ganhar 15 minutos para provar o aplicativo. Então, não tem desculpa para não provar o aplicativo. Eu super recomendo. É um ótimo jeito para achar um nativo para praticar e treinar seu inglês. Então agora vamos ver as reações desses professores. Eu vou mostrar um clipe de um brasileiro celebridade, um brasileiro famoso. E eles vão me falar o que eles acham desses famosos brasileiros falando em inglês.
Iraq and South Africa play same, but the second time I have control the match. Control the match, my equipe play in the left, the right, in the middle.
I can barely, I mean, I understand some of what he says, but he's so, you know, he has so many hesitations, you know, this constant, this constant thing, to that constant hesitation to an American, that's very, very, very distracting. That's extremely distracting. Of course, with the vuvuzelas in the background, it's also hard to make it out, but... To an American, I mean, I kind of know what he meant. They played well. Mm-hmm. They covered the whole field. He didn't, you know, I guess the idea was he doesn't know the idea then of whole field. They covered the whole pitch. Whole pitch is what he was searching for. Left, right, back, yeah. Middle. That's the whole pitch. Most Americans who are not teachers would not understand him at all.
Yeah. But you, so you mentioned you have a Brazilian student who's actually sent you this guy before.
Oh, yeah. And we make fun of him and he thinks he's so funny. And, oh, Aaron, you know, well, the Brazilian joke is, well, as long as you can speak better than Santana, the coach, you know, as long as you're speaking better than him, then you speak English, you know, just don't speak like he does. And then you're great.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah. That's great. That's really funny that you've heard of him or you know of him.
Students from Brazil love making fun of this person. Poor guy. To give the man credit, he could be an incredibly talented soccer player. He could be a really good footballer and a really great coach. You know, it's not fair to make fun of him just because he can't say anything. You know?
Funny. Whenever he said the word, I think it was and or and the. Okay, he would combine the words and the to and the. It was very... It's very kind of interesting to me how he like combined those sounds. It definitely makes it easier.
I could understand some words, but I think overall it was hard to understand what he was saying. Because without subtitles, it had been extremely hard.
Uh-huh. Yeah, yeah. The subtitles aren't great on that video, but he's done like, since then he's done commercials and stuff where they write a script for him that it'll be half in Portuguese, one sentence, and half in English. During the same sentence, so he kind of like, you can kind of see him struggling with he'll know one English word and then so he'll mix it in with the Portuguese sentence and vice versa. So
yeah. It's interesting, very interesting. But yeah, he has a very strong accent, mm-hmm. And then I think his voice being kind of deep, it makes it even harder to understand.
Yeah, I don't think even Brazilians can understand what he was saying in that video.
He was kind of hard to understand.
Just a little bit, right?
I could pick out keywords, and I could, my common sense could tell me what he was trying to say. But if I relied on his English, it was broken, very broken.
So this guy, he is an actor who plays Pablo Escobar in the Netflix series Narcos.
But I flew myself to Medellin, to Colombia, in order to, you know, to learn Spanish. And I booked myself in a university in a Spanish course for foreigners. So I was in a classroom with Japanese teenagers. And
how crazy is that?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've heard of him. He speaks really well. And his comfort is noticeable instantly. Mm-hmm. You know, There's no hesitation. He believes in himself. And I can tell that he believes in himself because he's willing to crack a joke and he's able to have, you know, an Americanized sense of humor to be able to convey humor. That's a huge clue that a student is advanced in English or anyone is advanced in any language when they're able to convey humor and understand humor. I think that's a really, really critical thing with his interview. Sure.
Yeah, yeah. And he, yeah, like you said, he's very comfortable with himself speaking. I think a lot of it has to do, too, with he played a role of a Colombian guy, you know, and he spoke Spanish all throughout Narcos with no problem. So he's just, he's a very talented guy linguistically.
You know, if a completely average native English speaker was walking down the street and he stopped them to ask them a question or he stopped them to have a conversation, you know, they would perfectly understand him. That's actually a question I get a lot from different students, like, oh, would a normal American understand me if I was talking, or would a normal English speaker understand me if I was talking? Seems to be a point of stress for some people. So he is an example, I think, of someone that no one would even question.
Okay, yeah, his English is amazing.
That's a lot better, right?
Definitely a lot better. Yeah. I mean, I think that he understands the subtle nuances of English. So yeah, definitely.
Yeah, especially with his pronunciation is really good, which is actually pretty common among Brazilians. Like even the very basic, you know, even Brazilians who have a very basic level of English, their pronunciation isn't all that different from native speakers. It's just, there's a few little quirky things that they do with some words and some sounds, but I think overall he has a pretty stereotypical Brazilian accent.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, the accent, it was noticeable, but not that much.
Yeah.
This is just a lot of fun. Since the first one, it's, I just love the process. I really enjoy the character. Just a fun character to play.
Wait, now you're saying that person is also Brazilian too? Are they Brazilian?
Yeah, yep. Everyone.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Well, of course. Then that's incredible. Okay, that would be C2. That would definitely be a very, 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 very advanced student. Right. If I think you're American, if your English sounds American, then you're doing really well.
So that guy is actually, have you seen the movie 300?
Yeah, actually I have, yeah.
So, you know, Xerxes, the Persian god, he's like the bald guy and he has a bunch of face jewelry.
Oh,
that's right. This guy.
Really? Wow. Yeah. Oh my goodness.
He looks
totally different,
right?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so he's another actor that's, you know, in some American films.
Honestly, I would have never guessed that he was Brazilian, but yeah, like his accent, even in the interview that he did, I mean, the video was amazing.
Yeah, yeah.
And when I was young, 9 years, 10 years old, I used to fight. I didn't like people call me Pelé because I didn't know exactly what it means. My name is Edson because of Thomas Edison.
I noticed a European touch with his English. I've never heard him before. He almost sounded at times almost French, even a little bit of French in there, a little bit of Spain, definitely a little bit of Portugal, but more Europe than Brazil for sure. That was interesting.
I think what's interesting for me with the soccer players is that, you know, these guys, they work with, all of their coworkers are from different places around the world, right? So they end up with this interesting mix of when they speak English, it's like, it could be British English mixed with American English, or when they speak Spanish, it could be, you know, they could have a Spanish accent that's really influenced by all these different places around the world. So it's always interesting to me to listen to the soccer players, you know, speak English or Portuguese or Spanish.
Yes. His intonation and pronunciation are Brazilian, but you can tell he's had some training. Obviously, he's an international soccer star, so he's had international exposure and over 30 years to work on his English because he's been around since I was a kid.
Is the Brazilian accent an accent you would be able to recognize right away, or is it a little bit like, oh, I don't quite know, you can't quite place it?
If you would know it's Latin, it's from Latin America, that much you can tell. But the only way I can tell a Brazilian person from, someone who speaks Spanish is when I have a word that begins with R, because in Brazilian, they pronounce R with an H. When they pronounce my name, that's when I know
edgy.
Where they're from. Yeah, when it's edgy, I know you're Brazilian. Yeah, how are you?
That's funny. That's great, yeah.
Bom, gente, acabei de editar o vídeo e eu descobri que eu esqueci de gravar a parte final do vídeo, então aqui está. Mas não esqueçam que vocês podem experimentar o aplicativo Cambly usando esse código. E é isso, espero que vocês tenham gostado desse vídeo e eu espero que vocês tenham uma boa semana. Tchau, tchau.